Air Transat Airlines flight 236 was heading from Toronto to Lisbon. It was midnight and that flight was cruising at an altitude of 39,000 feet height over the Atlantic Ocean. Pilot faces this situation every day and there was nothing abnormal in it. But there was something in the aircraft that was going to change entire situation in few hours. Here, let me tell you one thing. From a height of 39,000 feet over the Atlantic Ocean, the ground is not visible. The captain suddenly realized that the fuel in the aircraft was going to run out. It was a very scary situation for the two pilots because running out of fuel, that too, on the middle of Atlantic Ocean will happen only one thing, which is nothing but their death. What happened exactly? Let's find it out. Hi, this is Naveen. I am the host of today's interesting episode, which you will like definitely. This incident happened on 23rd August 2001. Air Transat Airline Airbus A330 was being prepared at Toronto Pearson Airport to travel from Toronto to Lisbon. It was supposed to be a 7 hours non-stop flight and therefore 48 metric tons of fuel was put into it. And after preparation, the boarding process was initiated. As per the local time, it was night 9 p.m. Flight 236 had a total of 293 passengers and 13 crew members, including two pilots on board. The flight captain, 48 years old Robert Peach, who had 16,000 hours of flight experience. The first officer, 28 year old Rick DeJager, also had 5,000 hours of experience, including 400 hours of flying the same Airbus aircraft A330, and it was only 2 years old aircraft, which is nothing but almost new one. At the time of flight takeoff, there is no issue with the experienced pilots in the plane and there is no issue within the aircraft because it was almost new and advanced aircraft. After completing all the flight checks, the pilots headed towards the runway with ATC permission. After takeoff, the pilot steered the plane across the Atlantic Ocean towards Lisbon. Within a few minutes, the flight reached at an altitude of 39,000 feet height over the Atlantic Ocean. Generally, on such long journey flights, the pilots have relatively very less work because the autopilot system will handle most of the work. The pilots has to mainly monitor the situation and keeps updating the control tower with their location and the status during that flight journeys. 4 hours have passed since the takeoff of flight 236. Still now, everything was normal. Most of the passengers in the cabin were slept due to late hours. The aircraft has reached exactly center of the Atlantic Ocean. At this moment, an issue occurred in the plane. According to Canadian time, at 1 o'clock in the night, the pilot noticed abnormal reading in engine number 2, which is right engine of the aircraft. The engine was showing high oil pressure, indicating low oil quantity and low oil temperature. The pilots were seeing this kind of error for the first time in their career. They immediately opened the flight manual and tried to understand more about the unusual error. Normally in running aircraft, the oil temperature increases with the time. However, in this situation, it was indicating low oil temperature, which is definitely not normal. Pilots couldn't find any information about this error in the flight manual. The pilots contacted Air Transat Maintenance Unit in Canada and informed them about this error. Unfortunately, the maintenance unit was also unaware of this kind of issues. They advised the pilot to keep monitoring the error and they will contact them short again. Although faulty oil readings were shown in the right engine of a plane, but there was no problem encountered in that plane. The pilot relaxed, thinking that faulty sensor was causing incorrect oil reading. After an half an hour, another advisory message was displayed in front of the captain. This message is not related to oil, but it is related to fuel. The fuel in the commercial airlines will be equally distributed in their wings. It was noticed that two wings of flight 236, the fuel was not equally distributed. The quantity of the fuel in the right wing was less than the quantity of fuel in the left. And this was not so serious because these kind of issues can be fixed by the pilot in the flight itself. The captain opened the crossfed valve to address this issue and which fuel started flowing from left wing to right wing. Within few minutes, the quantity of fuel in the both wings are equally distributed. In just 10 minutes later, the captain received again low fuel warning. This kind of situation no pilots want to face, especially when the flight is full of with passengers and that too in middle of Atlantic Ocean. The pilot noticed that fuel in the right wing was decreased again. If the combined fuels in both wing, it was not enough to reach Lisbon. This time, the issue became so serious. There were very limited options for landing the plane in the middle of Atlantic Ocean. They had only one option, that was Azores Island. These islands were part of Portuguese territory in the Atlantic Ocean, where there is an airport on this island called Terceira. The captain contacted Santa Maria ATC in the first place and informed them that they were going to land at that airport due to fuel shortage. But the pilot was still not sure whether they would be reaching the airport or they will land in the ocean. At that time, the aircraft had approximately 7 tons of fuel, which is around 7,000 kgs. We might think the fuel was a lot. In reality, it was only 6% of the A330's fuel capacity. And that too, it was decreasing rapidly. But the question was, why the fuel is getting decreased rapidly? Rapid decrease in fuel can occur only in one case. There might be fuel leakage somewhere in the aircraft. To find out, the captain gave instructions to the flight crew member to go and monitor the trailing edge of the wing. If there is a fuel leak, then surely there will be an indication. But due to darkness, the crew of a flight unable to find any fuel leakage indication. Now the condition was that 1 ton of fuel was decreasing for every 5 minutes. Now it's all clear to the pilot, there was somewhere fuel leakage is happening. Now they had a fuel that the engine of airplanes can run only for 25 minutes. Within these 25 minutes, it is not even possible to reach Terceira Airport. Meanwhile, the captain and first officer were continuously in contact with maintenance unit and ATC. The maintenance unit gave instructions to the captain that to descend aircraft from 39,000 feet high to 20,000 feet down. But the captain declined to do so as they believed that even if the fuel leakage was confirmed, it wouldn't be possible to ascend the aircraft back up. At least they still have an option of gliding at 39,000 feet height for now. In the next few minutes, all doubts were cleared when the fire erupted in the right engine of aircraft. After seeing all this, all the passengers were into panic mode who were sleeping peacefully. The aircraft had only 4.5 ton of fuel was left and the only one engine was working. With just one engine, it was not possible to continue cruising. On the other hand, the emergency landing was declared at Terceira Airport. Fire trucks and emergency crew were initiated their preparations to handle any kind of situation. In meantime, what was feared that was happened. Because left engine caught fire due to running at full thrust. And now flight 236 began gliding over the Atlantic Ocean without engines. Here, the captain decision not to drop the aircraft 20,000 feet down proved to be correct. Due to the shutdown of both the engines, it was dark inside the plane because the electrical system of the plane also runs due to the engine. Now the Terceira Airport was 120 kilometers away and the aircraft had descended to 30,000 feet down. The captain has to cross the distance only by gliding. The darkness and pin drop silence of passengers in the cabin had created an atmosphere of fear. The worst case scenario was that if the aircraft couldn't reach the airport, then it would have to land on ocean. For this reason, the crew in the plane preparing the passengers for a potential water landing. Landing in the ocean is dangerous from every side. Even if the passengers survive the impact, they may drown in the water. If they do not drown in the water, they may die of hypothermia due to cold water. Normally, it was very difficult to glide a passenger plane without engine. Everything was dependent on the plane pitch control, which the pilot was manually controlling using the stick. The altitude of plane was dropping at the rate of 2000 feet per minute. That means next 15 minutes, the plane might reach the Terceira Airport or it would land up in the ocean. When the distance of plane was 15 kilometers from Terceira Airport, it was gliding at 13,000 feet height. Normally at this distance, the flight should glide around 3,000 feet high. Now if the pilot lowers his altitude by performing a nosedive, the speed of the plane will be very fast and in this situation, the possibility of crash landing is very high. That's why the pilot decided to perform a 360 degree turn right there. Once the turn was completed, the distance from airport remained the same while the altitude had dropped to 5,000 feet. This altitude was still high but enough to make another 360 degrees turn. Therefore, the pilot aligned the plane position with the runway and executed a series of S-turns. Due to the S-turns, the plane distance from the runway increased and it get more time to lower its altitude. In normal conditions, during landing, the flaps were extended to create a drag and engine thrust is increased. causing the plane nose to pitch up, but flight 236 did not have engines. That's why this landing was very different from normal landing and very dangerous. The pilot had only one chance to land the plane, either to make it or break it. At the end, the plane was landed with a strong touch on runway. 8 out of 12 tires were burst. There have been some difficulty in stopping the plane, but finally came to halt while skidding. As soon as the plane stopped, the fire broke out its landing gear, which was immediately controlled by the airport crew. Flight 236 was the first and last passenger plane in aviation history to hold the record for the longest glide time without engines. When the investigation done regarding the fuel leakage in the right engine, it was revealed that before takeoff in Toronto, the maintenance crew had replaced a part of engine, but the part was belonged to different plane. Due to loose fitting, it caused vibration which burst the fuel line passage nearby. After this incident, Airbus installed a new system that will allow pilots to detect fuel leakage during the flight in future. 1 year later, First Officer Robert Pitch and Dirk Dejager were honored with a Superior Airmanship Award for performing a deadly stick landing on Airbus A330. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and hit like button of this video. I will meet you in next interesting episode. Until then, this is Naveen Sakibanda signing off.